to please the most liberal part of the Democrat base, and it just didn't end well for the Democrats.
Congressman Gosar, people watching this across the country, I mean, we were at a restaurant for lunch, and people walking by kind of look up for a second, and they just move on. I mean, I'm not saying it's not important because the Democrats think they're going to finally get Trump, but what did you take away from all of this? Were you concerned? I mean, he was talking about the Southern District of New York. He brought up, well, there are other crimes, but I can't talk about them.
Well, it was a sad day that this is a pathological liar brought in front of Congress as the first witness for this hearing. It just shows you how far the Democrats have gone. I hope that they realize that they should love this country more than they hate Donald Trump.
Well, that's not even close. Congressman Chaffetz, I mean, you know the moment I'm talking about. Well, can we play it, guys? This is where he was asked about whether he knows of any crimes the president committed. Let's watch.
Unfortunately, this topic is actually something that's being investigated right now by the Southern District of New York, and I've been asked by them not to discuss and not to talk about these issues. Those are part of the investigation that's currently being looked at by the Southern District of New York. I am currently working with them right now on several other issues.
You get the sense, Congressman Chaffetz, that that was Cohen's way of kind of tweaking Trump when he's over there in Vietnam trying to negotiate perhaps a peace deal here. Your thoughts?
Well, I think what the country and Congress got to see is what Mueller saw, and that is a self-described fool. They didn't save Cohen to testify against somebody else. The Southern District of New York is not going to use him to testify to somebody else. He's terribly discredited. He's a liar. He's a cheat. He deserves to go to prison. He is going to prison. He was a terrible witness. I don't think the Democrats actually proved or demonstrated anything other than he is a liar and a cheat. But the one thing that actually came out where Cohen has been consistent is he said, I have not witnessed anything personally in 10 years sitting by Donald Trump that has to do with collusion. He didn't have anything specific about the allegation of racism or any of the other things. I mean, at the end of the day, I think the Democrats are left empty-handed other than parading somebody and choosing a date that's offensive to this country and trying to displace the news and the pinnings of what Donald Trump is trying to do and accomplish in Vietnam.
Congressman Comer, Judge Napolitano on this network said what he watched made him think that there could be four felonies committed by the president. Do you see any of that?
I don't see that. You know, they haven't proven to me anything thus far that's a felony, much less an impeachable offense by the president. They obviously don't have anything with respect to collusion. I agree exactly with what Jason Chaffetz just said. They're trying to pivot. They always try to play the race card. They're going to try to do everything to embarrass the president. When you have a business empire the size of President Trump's, if you dig deep enough, you're always going to find where you omitted something or didn't calculate something exactly right. The president is clearly in the right on all this.
All right, guys, thank you so much. And President Trump, Kim Jong-un, will speak to the media very soon. We're going to bring you to that moments away when it happens, so stay right there.